So I'm John Walsh. I'm the chief scientist at HIO's Center, International Arctic Research Center. And following on HIO's lead, I'm just curious, how many here are not from Alaska? So we do have a few. Well, this will be a summary of a report we released just a couple of months ago on the changing environment in Alaska. It's a report that is available on the counter here for those who'd like copies. I'm just going to give a few highlights of it. A couple of comments on it. The report was put together by Rick Tolman, myself, and Heather McFarland, who's over there on the far corner. We're the three parties behind the report. The report is an attempt to summarize the evidence for what's been going on in Alaska, and it focuses on the past several years. What we're out to do here is say how the last few years have been different from the longer-term historical record in Alaska. We did not get into predictions for the future. We did not get into climate models. We did not get into attribution of the changes. We just are trying to present the facts. And we're presenting them in the spirit that Alaska is in many ways a bellwether, or a sort of a canary in the coal mine, as they say, for climate change. So hopefully this will alert other areas to the reality of changes that could be on their way at some point in the future. So the report is, the cover of the report's at the upper left, and what I'll do is just highlight a few of the findings that are in here. These are based on the types of data that HIO just talked about, historical records that have been compiled from various sources. We've tried to bring them together into a synthesis about how Alaska's environment is being affected. The upper right diagram is a summary of the temperature changes in the last 5 years in Alaska. It's actually how the last 5 years have differed from the historical past. And what stands out there is that not all seasons are warming equally. It turns out that autumn and winter especially have warmed the most. And the winter warming in some parts of the state is 5 to 10 degrees. That's saying the last 5 years have been 5 to 10 degrees warmer, it's Fahrenheit warmer, than the historical record going back to the 1920s. We don't have a precipitation figure here, but we do try to show in the report that Alaska has been wetter than usual in the last 5 years. In fact, in parts of the interior, the last 5 years have been about 30% wetter than their longer-term average. So we're seeing a wetter and a warmer climate. The precipitation also shows up in the shortened snow season. This diagram is a depiction of how the snow season has been compressed. The snows have been coming later and melting off earlier over the last 20 years or so. We also highlight changes in sea ice, in particular the sea ice cover in the Bering Sea. This diagram in the middle of the right-hand column shows you a record of Bering sea ice extent, which has just dramatically dropped off the chart almost, in the sense that there's been essentially no sea ice for a large part of the winter in the Bering Sea for the last two winters. There's been nothing like that in the historical record that we have. So unprecedented sea ice in the Bering Sea. And farther north, the open water season has been between 2 and 3 months longer than it was 30 or 40 years ago. The fire seasons have been becoming more severe. There's a diagram at the lower left showing the number of days when smoke has been reducing visibility, when smoke has actually reduced visibility in Fairbanks. The airport reports these things for aviation interests. And there's been an increased frequency of smoky days in the interior over the last couple of decades. A couple of the things we don't show here are that parts of Alaska are showing what we call greening. The vegetation has been becoming leafier. That's mainly true of the tundra to the north. There's more of a mixed record of vegetative changes in the interior. There have been examples of migrating wildlife. Beavers in particular seem to be expanding their habitat in the northwest Alaska, farther north than they used to be. And one last item that we highlight in the report is the actions that are being taken in Alaska to deal with climate change. Turns out that a large number of communities have developed climate adaptation plans to deal with change. So there's the recognition that change is something to be dealt with in Alaska. We show in this report that it's happening, and it's being acted on now by the communities in the state. So with that, I'll stop and take any questions, and I think Hio is also available for the questions. The report is available online, and all the graphics are available online, but it is not an interactive website at this point. That's an interesting possibility for down the road. I think there was another question. No? There are copies of the report here, so help yourselves.